When was the first time opening an email resulted in disaster? Let's talk about the Malicious virus, the malware that changed the internet. Back in the 90s, malware wasn't the industry it is today. Things like boot sector viruses spread via floppy disks, so you'd only infect one or two computers at a time. That was until March 26, 1999. When a man named David Lee Smith posted a file on an internet news group using a hacked AOL account. The post promised access to paywalled pornography websites. Once you clicked on the file named list.doc, you'd get the passwords, but you'd also get Melissa. Melissa, reportedly named after a stripper Smith met in Florida, was a macro virus that targeted Microsoft Office systems. If you opened the file and happened to have Microsoft Outlook, the most popular mailing program at the time, you'd also send out the virus to 50 other people on your contact list. The subject of the email was disguised as a message from someone the recipient knew. The contents of the letter read, "Here's that document you asked for. Don't show anyone else." Smiley wink face. It also had the list.doc file attached. At the time, there was no such thing as a virus spreading through email. Not really. So people opened the attachment. Over and over and over again. Within hours, it had reached the mailing systems of corporate networks, and the sheer amount of traffic slowed them to the point where some networks had to be temporarily shut down. Over 5 days, Melissa affected 1 million email accounts and disrupted more than 300 organizations, including Microsoft, Intel Corp., the United States Marine Corps, and parts of the Air Force.
What it did do was cause us to go back late Friday and work like we had pre-computer days. We called people, we faxed them, we telephoned them.
It was the fastest spreading virus in the history of the internet to date. It caused about $80 million in damages in the US and about $1.1 billion across the globe. But even those infected got lucky. The virus itself wasn't intended to steal information or destroy infected machines. It did corrupt Word documents if you opened them at a specific time that matched the date on your computer. But that's about it. Most damage came from overloaded networks. David Lee Smith got a 20-month prison sentence and a $5,000 fine. Yet, the internet was never the same again. Melissa was a wake-up call. In response, the FBI opened a new cyber division focused solely on digital crimes. Unfortunately, Melissa also worked as an inspiration. It began a transformation of digital threats and the very landscape of the internet as we know it. And just a year later, a more harmful, more infectious virus would spread across the web, wreaking more havoc than anyone had ever seen. That's for a different episode of Behind the Hacks.